Which spikes your blood sugar more, a banana or a bowl of berries? Most people guess wrong. The kind of fruit, how you eat it, when you eat it, and how much you eat are what decide your numbers. Stay with me. I'll show you how to enjoy fruit and keep your glucose lines steady. Think about the last time fruit made you sleepy an hour later. That wasn't you failing. That was timing. Same food, different order, smaller spike. You should know who's talking before you change that plate. I'm Dr. Yaz, quadruple board certified endocrinologist and obesity medicine specialist. I'm a mom of two and also have diabetes. I help busy people get real wins without crazy rules. I'm gonna keep this simple. Clear picks, real portions, and exactly when to eat fruit so you can enjoy it without the crash. Bananas make people nervous and berries get a free pass, but the size and ripeness change the hit more than folks realize. See, as fruit ripens, more starch turns into sugar and it lands faster. A small banana with a little green hits way slower than a big spotty banana. So buy small bananas or eat half of a large one. Pair it with Greek yogurt or cottage cheese or peanut butter and eat it last in your meal. The one change that moves a big spike into a smaller bump. A small banana sliced over thick Greek yogurt after an omelet can spike less than 2 cups of blueberries eaten on their own alone on an empty stomach. So I want you to stop judging the fruit by the name. Fruit is a snack, sounds clean, but alone fruit on an empty stomach is the move that backfires. Even the good fruits can spike, so berries, apples, or pears with the peel, citrus, and kiwi are friendlier because they come with more fiber and a steady hit. When you eat fruit matters as much as what you eat, so put the fruit at the end of the meal, not at the start of the meal. This isn't fancy. It's just repeatable, even on your busiest day, and still gives you that sweet fix. So you can use 1 to 2 servings a day from this list and place them at the end of meals. So a cup of berries or half a cup after eggs is very different from a cup of berries before breakfast. Let's clean up the lines you've heard that just aren't true. Fruit is off limits for diabetes is wrong. Whole fruit fits when you place it right and measure it. All bananas are bad is wrong. It's the size, the ripeness, the pairing, and the order that decides what happens with this. All watermelon is evil is wrong. It depends on how much and where it is in your meal. Smoothies are all healthy is wrong. Liquid carbs move fast unless you build protein first and keep the fruit to one serving. Some traps that look healthy but fool almost every diabetic. Juice pours fast sugar. Big handfuls of dried fruit packed into a tiny space. Mega smoothie bowls with 3 fruits, a juice space are desserts wearing gym clothes. Very ripe tropical fruit eaten alone hits hard because those sugars come quick and the portions get big. For juice, I honestly love avoiding it, but if you go for it, dilute it, or get one of those 25 calorie ones, they often remove the sugar from them and use a sugar substitute. For dried fruit, think 1 or 2 dates with maybe cheddar cheese or walnuts after lunch, not the bag by itself. And if you're gonna have a smoothie, start with yogurt or whey, and then maybe add 1 piece of fruit or half a banana, and make sure to add some chia or flax, and definitely skip adding any juice to it. For mangoes and pineapple or watermelon, make sure those are smaller servings and pair with cottage cheese or feta. Now, portion creeps is a silent problem. A handful of grapes often becomes a bowl. They can all fit, but you have to keep a leash on the dose, okay? So very small. I want you to look up what is a portion of that fruit that's 15 grams of carbs. That would probably be accurate. Now, you might think you need a gym to blunt out a spike, but you don't. You need 10 minutes right after you eat. Working your muscles soak up glucose fast. So a short walk right after dinner often helps more than longer walk later. When you set your fork down, set a 10-minute timer and just move. Walk the block, pace the hallway, or clean the kitchen. Can you flatten your numbers in 3 days without changing your grocery list? Yes. You change the order, the portion, not your whole life. And on day 1, swap any juice for whole citrus at the end of the meal. On day 2, add 1 cup of berries to your day, but only after protein food. And on day 3, take a 10-minute walk immediately after the carbs. During those 3 days, I want you tracking your energy, your cravings, and your numbers and write them down. Tell me in the comments what happened. I bet it went well. Comment cheat sheet and I'll send you the fruit pairing cheat with portions and 9 easy plates you can copy. Next week, I'll show you the best and worst vegetables for diabetes. So subscribe so you don't miss it.